funny guy. I think you're going to like him. CJ Leonzo.
Hey, pendejos. How y'all doing tonight? All right. I'm actually surprised, like earlier, you know, that was the first time I ever seen white people complain about not wanting to sit in the front. That was weird. I'm not actually originally from Clovis. I'm originally from a little town called Malaga. The thing that I like about Malaga is that the population stays the same. You know, it's like when a baby's born, a baby daddy leaves. You see what I'm saying? That's the Mexican way, you know? It's like now how I explain, you know, like how they're, oh my, right now, the whole thing, you know, like about the kids, you know, they're actually getting taken from the U.S. and then they're sending their parents back to Mexico and stuff. I think like, shit, they're on vacation now. It's like, shoot, oh my, honestly, there's some of my cousins there. They're like, hey, we got to bring them here to the house. Not happening. Not happening. I'm like, why? I said, because we already got 15 people from when the government shutdown was there and they still haven't left. It's like, can you imagine 15 people in a two-bedroom house and only one fucking bathroom having to end up getting in line? I might end up by the time when they're all done, it's going to look like a damn Cinco de Mayo porta potty at the end. Fucking horrible. But I ended up moving into the suburbs and here in Clovis. I love it. Fucking love it. But there was a thing that actually caught my eye that I never knew in my old neighborhood. It's called the Neighborhood Watch. Yeah. Honestly, if that was in my hood, honestly, it would have been the neighborhood snitches. But the way the neighborhood watch for us in our hood, it's just like, you know, you just got fucking robbed, and the neighborhood watched. That's how it happens. That's actually how it happens. You know, and I got a dysfunctional family, Mexican family. All right, I'm just going to leave it at that. I would say, my family are like the keepers of secrets. Like the Vatican, but more Catholic. That's kind of like how it is with them. But you know, I heard about, you know, I got 3 kids, and I got 2 baby mamas. All right, that's not going anywhere either. Honestly, I really don't want it, because honestly, I have 2 baby mamas, but you know, out of courtesy, during Mother's Day, I ended up sending them a text message saying, you know, happy Mother's Day, and just to let you know, when you get the child support check, get yourself something nice on me. But honestly, she found out about that, and it backfired, and then afterwards, when Father's Day came a couple days ago, she ended up pulling up with my son in a new fucking car saying, look what you got me. I was like, happy Father's Day, thank you for not pulling out. Shit. And then she ended up having like a fat ring on her finger. I barely found out about my dad. He sent me a text message and then he just said, guess who said yes? And I said, yeah, and her fat fucking fingers are just saying no. Cut it off now. Shit. But I actually love my son, and I just ended up getting a call from, you know, like my son, you know, he flipped off the camera. At school for his school pictures, and then she ended up saying, she's all, well, he flipped off the camera, now I gotta go talk to his teachers. She's all, what am I gonna say? I'm like, what am I gonna say? And I was just like, well, I don't know what to say. So I know where he got this attitude from. I said, hey, he's a good kid, he's got good grades, he's not getting 2 girls pregnant at the same time, so I think that's damn near perfect. She's all, oh, I have to go say, what do you want me to say? I said, well, you like fucking Trump, tell him it was a fucking political statement. I'm CJ Leonzo. Thank you very much.
All right. Next up is a new face. I don't believe we've seen him here before. Go ahead and give it up for Aaron Schuover. Schoonover. Gotcha. All right. Give it up.